fay lempo warugal la ci kep ko xamne domi rew mi nga ak ñu fi dekk bu fekke ne ci atmi sa kom kom wessuna ñaar fuka ak ñenti juney dalasi mbete wer bu nekk di nga am lu tollu ci ñaari juney dalasi lempo si la nguur gi di sukandeku ngir liggey yokute rew mi GRA moy banhas bu nguuri gambia sas ngir mu fayeku lepp luy lempo ci biir rew mi betaxna GRA di yegal fay kati lempo yi ne warugal la pour ñu fay luñu naan withholding tax on contract payment manam bepp contract bu way joxe te ci biir rew mi lañu tokon xaliss contract bi ngeen nangoto war nga ci wañi ci xayma témèr bu nekk fuka bu fekke ne contract bi dekkut ci biir rew mi bu boba di nga wara wañi témèr bu nekk fuka ak juroom li moy lempo buñu naan withholding tax on contract payment li moy lempo bi nga xamne yow mi joxe contract warugal la nga wolbatiku dem feyiko ci makani GRA tax office bu la gëna jégué mbété ci banki GRA jaglel pour fay lempo war nga djébal lempo bi ci diri fukki fan ak juroom ganaw bi nga wañé ci xaaliss ci contract bi amul ben contracto buñu téggil fay lempo bi ana mu fekk né nguri gambia ñoko djégalé bolé ci project yi nga xamné mbotay ndimbali ñokoy dépense GRA di fayeku lempo ngir yokkutu réew mi
diwli lanni maro lanni
fop lanni
awa jodi mi anda honno gerde te ngal do sabbo e ngal do ibrahima jonnal taw joni mi anda se yahay kapiti ki nyawlo de ha hum pondire ma ko esko nonne warude
ah wade no
ane gore ibrahima ma ko to woni
mo amerik
ah ko amerika woni kare hum pita ki fi be musibe me baluo
baluo
be andanda kala ko wada wonde aduno si arrivi e juude mabbe a jonnay do departement gambia har no wet aya ata kadi taw ko mbudi din no jawi walla no jippi be halantama ko kala ko falda ko reese sengo nyamete il nepa maro basal pomdete kala ko rewi dom a hendo to har no wet kadi wona dum non tu be abbe jonnira mobile phone si ko dum kadi laptop kala ko wayro de jibe ay cash bawa be wa ma jonnude eh kadi sa wala on pita de ko webi etu google account ma joni data ton wada download app mabbe on ayay kala ko humpi may mabbe ton be webi ama
ka wonta woy aduna on
kala ko wawda
a jonnana e wondo kaleji men gambia do depense
harano webi ama si dun no fono nebi immo den joni mi do tama ka place mabbe jan
wadel don
iya heba ko fala
wadel ki sam
Islamic microfinance is becoming an increasingly popular mechanism for poverty alleviation, especially for developing countries around the world. This microfinance service adheres to the principles of Islam as a form of social responsibility. Yona Islamic Microfinance is the Islamic microfinance of choice in the Gambia, trustworthy and reliable. At Yona Islamic Microfinance, we provide savings products, current accounts, financing products in conformity with Islam. In addition, Yona Islamic Microfinance also offers local and international remittances, Takaful Fund, management of Zakat, management of Awqaf, trading and investment, and building of strategic partnerships to bring financial services to the doorstep of the poor with donor projects, madrasas, youth organizations, women groups, and farmer organizations. Make a choice with Yona Islamic Microfinance today. For more information on Yona Islamic Microfinance, call 377-2151 or 9832-151 or visit Yona head office at Tipa Garage, Bakote, or visit any Yona branch located countrywide near you.
Former Gambian Vice President Badra Aliou Diouf, who passed away on Wednesday, January 18, 2023, was a career civil servant before his ascent to the vice presidency, a position he held until his demise from a short illness with seeking medication treatment in Delhi, India. Diouf was a student at Armitage High School and trained as a teacher at Yundum Teachers College. He held a Bachelor degree of Education from the University of Bristol, a degree in English Literature from the University of London, and a Master's degree in Development Economics from the University of Bath. Juve began his career as a qualified teacher, teaching English at the Gambia College. He was then head of the Department of Languages and Literature at Nusrat High School. He was the permanent secretary at the Ministry of Education for many years. In March 2002, he was transferred to the Ministry of Local Government and Lands as permanent secretary. In a career full of impressive feats, Juf also worked as the World Bank Election Officer to the Gambia. In this role, he assisted the Higher Education Minister, Mariama Sar Cisse, in introducing a new education policy to the Gambia. He also urged the Gambian tourism sector to remove from the routine tourism and to be more proactive. He also held a World Bank project supported to NGO Network Tango, which had a budget of $220,000 and lasted from 2010 to 2013. The stated purpose of which was to enhance the efficiency and accountability of non-governmental organizations in delivering basic services to the poor in the member country. In 2013, Joe visited various project sites in the Gambia along with Ministry of Agriculture officials to gain a better understanding of the various challenges they face. In 2014, Juf was appointed an education specialist in Dakar, Senegal, for the World Bank.
We should be able to identify what is best for us. John Dewey says, in the multitude of educations, education is lost. It is that lost education that you should find and bring it back, which is qualitative, relevant, appropriate, and ministers to employment, gainful employment.
From February 2017 to 4th of May 2022, Badra Aliou Diouf was the Minister of Higher Education, Research, Science and Technology of the Gambia. His Excellency Badra Aliou Diouf is admired by his colleagues and officers under him as a visionary leader who is proactive and meticulous in details. He has created a culture where if you work with him, you have to be on your feet. During his time in office as Minister of Higher Education, His Excellency Badra Diouf has successfully spearheaded a series of reforms in the tertiary and higher education system of the Gambia. This includes the transformation of Gambia Technical Training Institute into University of Applied Science, Engineering and Technology, the transformation of the Gambia College into a teacher education university, and the transformation of Management Development Institute into Gambia Institute of Public Administration and Management. In addition, the decentralization of technical and vocational education and training in different parts of the country was done during his tenure as Minister of Higher Education, Research, Science and Technology. These institutions include the newly established Julangel Skills Center in Base, Mansakonko Skills Center, and Ndemban Skills Center, among others. His Excellency Badra Aliou Diouf is a firm believer that a skilled nation is a wealthy nation.
The Gambian people have great expectations. And it reminds me of two writers. Charles Dickens wrote Great Expectations. Chinua Achebe wrote No Longer at Ease. The Gambian people have great expectations, and they are no longer at ease. To make them at ease, we have to deliver the development agenda of this government, our government.
Juf was not only intellectually inclined, but also an expert technician, who is a leader who loves to uplift others by building their capacities. At the Ministry of Higher Education, Research, Science and Technology, he has encouraged the capacity building of many of his staff, such as cleaners, orderlies, drivers, and technicians to attain degrees, diplomas, and certificates.
I think he's a born technocrat. For him, he was not interested in, you know, in political gimmicks or sorry. In fact, if you observe that even the time when he was in the cabinet up to this very day, you would hardly see him in any political meeting.
Yeah.
He was not interested in politics. What he was interested was, you know, to do his work and serve the Gambian public. He was a technocrat, definitely.
President Adama Barrow appointed him as vice president after his re-election in December 2021 for a second term.
I, Badara Aliou Diouf, do swear that I will execute the functions of the office of vice president of the Republic of the Gambia without fear or favor, affection or ill will, according to the constitution and other laws of the Gambia. So help me God.
Upon his appointment to the vice presidency, VP Diouf highlights the need to work together and address the high cost of living in the Gambia and work towards solving the prevailing security concerns.
We have to work as a team. And to work as a team, we need to consult, we need to coordinate, we need to cooperate, we need to dialogue. Working in silos would fragment the development agenda and therefore the realization of the aspirations of the NDP would be undermined. So it is important that we work as a team. We work as a group. Hence the name cabinet. That's what it is. You know, it's a family. Let us work as a team. Move the development agenda of this country to fulfill the expectations of the person who appointed us to this position. And by extension, to fulfill the expectations of the Gambia, there are some pressing challenges that are facing us recently. One is the crisis of the rising cost of living. And I would challenge the Minister of Finance, the Governor of Central Bank, the incoming Minister of Trade, the GRA people, to come together, work with the Chamber of Commerce and the business community to see how we could mitigate these difficult times. The second challenge is the security situation in this country. Again, the same challenge goes to the Minister of Interior, to the Minister of Defense, to the security outfits of this country, and see how best we can address those things so that this place is safe for everybody, it is safe for investment, it is safe for tourism.
Last June, following the end of the 2022 cabinet retreat held at the Sadaura Karaba Jora Conference Center, Vice President Badara Aliou Diouf tasked all government ministers to start implementing the recommendations of the retreat and report to the executive as a whole with immediate effect. At the close of the retreat, the Vice President assured his colleagues that he is making remarks with great consideration of the Gambian people, who he said have great expectations and are no longer at ease. Vice President Dr. Badara Aliou Diouf, in addition to tasking the ministers for the immediate implementation of the recommendation, also highlighted the significance of state protection. He expressed dissatisfaction with the conduct of public affairs, saying Gambians had great expectations and a business as usual would not lead to a decisive change.
It cannot be business as usual in the civil service. We go to security. We would have to mobilize resources for them to be more effective. We don't have to take security for granted. In security, you never say it cannot happen or it will not happen. It happens when you least expect it to happen, because that's the time they strike. They catch you unawares. We will have to make the police, the drug squad, the military more effective, more efficient, but more importantly, more professional.
In what is said to be one of his last public appearances, former Gambian Vice President Badara Aliou Diouf, accompanied by senior government officials and security heads, toward flood-affected communities in the Greater Banjul area. VP Juf began his tour in Ibo Town before moving to the Bakwate Market area, Serekunda Market, Churches Town, and Sukuta Nemasu. During the tour, he expressed his sympathy for the plight of the affected communities while urging the Minister of Local Government and Lands to work with relevant stakeholders to solve the problem.
I mean, tomorrow we'll call Gumworks to the office and then they will have to explain to us what happened, and we'll also have to send them here and we'll see how best we can salvage the situation. These things cannot just continue on like this. No, because if this was something that was commissioned for them to start before the rains, by now they should have completed it. Or should have factored an alternative, bearing in mind that when the rains come, it would result to something like this, so that there's an alternative route for the Yuna people and the Mariamakunda people in terms of, you know, communicating, but more importantly for the Yuna people. This is unacceptable.
VP Juf, who is cared for and loved by many Gambians, also appeared on many occasions before the National Assembly to answer questions regarding his work.
Thank you so much, Honorable Speaker. My supplementary question that I want to ask the Vice President, do the government of the day have any plan to relocate those inhabitants who are living within the flood areas?
Yes, we have plans. I am not sure whether I forgot to indicate that, but as I said during the retreat, we had medium to long-term plans. And there is provision in the plan to relocate and resettle, where government would have the layouts for them on high ground and move them there. And where it involves compensation, we'll take care of it, you know. So there are plans to do that.
His Excellency, Vice President, for coming up with a permanent solution as far as flood is concerned. Notwithstanding, I want you to inform the August body the temporal solution on flood, because right now the permanent solution is coming, but what I want to whether there is any contingency in place so that before the completion or the implementation of the project, whether there is any contingency that can mitigate flood. Thank you.
Well, thank you very much. We dealt with the ones that happened the past few weeks, and we hope and pray that we don't have something like that. But in case, it will follow a similar pattern, you know, for the time being, until we put our acts in order and deal with them comprehensively.
The former Vice President of the Gambia, Badr Ali Juf, died in India on Wednesday, January 18, 2023, following a brief illness. The announcement was made via the official Twitter handle of President Adama Barrow early Wednesday morning. The Vice President left the Gambia about 3 weeks ago to seek medical treatment in India.
Badr Ali was a very honest man.
Mm-hmm.
He was an intellectual of the highest caliber.
Mm-hmm.
He was very straightforward.
Mm-hmm.
He was very, very strong in governance issues for now.
Mm-hmm.
And Molombi Alonko, he was a towering figure in cabinet.
Listen.
Momoy Alonko cabinet kwa Katenyami. Molbika Kambel kwa Bela.
Hade.
And everybody was always looking forward to Badr Ali Juf's contribution.
In 18 months, Fatou, that those buildings in Brikama,
yeah,
for the new campus of University of Applied Science and Technology that he worked for will be delivered.
Wow.
Badr Ali will not be around.
Wow.
You know, I talked to him 1 week ago, and he was very happy to talk to me, and he started cracking jokes.
Wow.
So I had hope that he will come back, and you know, 2 days ago I called, but I got the wife, and he told me he was sleeping.
Wow.
Not knowing that I will not meet him
again,
you know, and but yesterday, I received the daughter, and yeah, we were talking. Yes, yesterday. Yeah. You know, for me, as if through the daughter, he was saying goodbye to the ministry. whatever.
Wow.
You know? So it's very painful. It's very, very sad to. He's a friend. He's the guy who.
Oh. Oh. Yeah.
He's the guy who spoke well of me. He's talked to the president.
Wow. Oh, yeah. Wow. What an emotion coming out there. All the people that dealt with it. Yeah, go ahead.
But then I did not know my parents. He didn't want to know anybody, but he knew me. He wanted to just celebrate me.
Wow.
He went all out.
He was such a pillar.
Brother
Yusuf was very simple, very honest, but above all, he was a very tough guy.
Yeah.
Yeah, in order to satisfy Brother Yusuf, you have to be equally tough.
Yeah.
Even though he was vice president, he was always honest. He spoke truth to power.
Yes.
He didn't shy away from telling the president and the cabinet colleagues, you know, what he felt about what he felt.
Yeah.
And for me, honestly, that brings the best out of him.
Yes.
Having a state minister, later promoted to the level of a vice president, who wasn't afraid to speak his mind.
Yeah.
You know, who would always say it as it is supposed to be. He would raise his finger and criticize where he felt something was wrong.
Yeah.
I think not only in Gambia, but in the rest of Africa, I think that's what we need for our societies to move on, to progress like other societies that we continue to draw from and to emulate for our own posterity.
And Lester Sum, who served all his life for the betterment of this country, has fallen. It was indeed a moment of grief for all of us, not only me or the late Badara's family, but His Excellency President Adama Barrow and the entire nation. Badara has been true to his life. He has worked towards, during his time, helping to mold, especially young people, and he guided all of us through the straight path. I've worked with him closely when he was the Minister for Higher Education, Research, Science and Technology, and as well as Vice President. He has guided me personally as president. He has supported and I've benefited from his vast wealth of experience. And I've known Badara to be an astute individual who was upright, who was true to himself, to his people, to his peers, and to his colleagues. And he was very frank.
Badara Keta Moreti, me along ko. Donc din kende ya taman se ro dole mate fanal momin na baluwo mu wi be keta sobe yale ala baluwo mu mi be keta sobe yale tin tenene man badara je ku kono mi mutulun ku wani ka kuma si ay go ku ke wato minna nte balon na wato minna abe education nen permanent secretary I jeke nyamin nsa fala wato le form nye education policy the most popularized education policy that wo bota je anata nata local government bira futa ta local government e kamira e local government ne found karama education from karam fang
hade
nyin kam manyaton kaya taman seri kendo min aya keje
on a Thursday 19th January 2023, President Adama Barrow and his cabinet ministers, including other Gambians, gathered at State House to sign the condolence book for the late VP, Badra Aliou Diouf.
This is a sad moment for me and it's a sad moment for the entire country that is Gambia. I received the news, a real shock, and I still cannot come to terms with the passing of my Vice President, Badara Aliou Diouf.
It is a day of mourning. My heart is full. He has been my friend. He has been my mentor. He has been my defender. VP would agree to any proposal or assignment that I asked him or I requested from him, and would attend all the meetings that I, even if the request is late, he will agree and then attend. Definitely, Allah has decreed that he has gone, and that is what we are all waiting for. It's either sooner or later. I ask Allah by his unique mercy to grant him Jannah through Firdaus al-A'la. Our deeds will never be enough to grant us Jannah, only Allah's mercy. May Allah rain his abundant mercy on him and grant him Jannah through Firdaus al-A'la until we meet in the hereafter. Amin ya Rabbin.
He has always been there for the cabinet. He has been a mentor for most of us. And he has always been extremely helpful. So Badra is a great guy that the country has lost, that the cabinet has lost, that every Gambian person should remember as somebody who has contributed immensely to our nation.
I remember him to be very hardworking, one who encourages us to perform to the maximum. And wherever he feels that you are not performing well enough, he tries to encourage you to improve. We found him to be very supportive to the president, and all of us will really feel his absence.
He was married to Mrs. Fatou Sonko Diouf, and they are blessed with several children. President Barrow, who expressed profound shock at the passing of Mr. Diouf, remembers his vice president as a very serious, level-headed, patriotic, dedicated, competent, and honest Gambian who spent his entire life trying to improve mankind. The announcement of his passing was met with an outpouring of mourning, support for his family, and condolence messages from Gambians both at home and abroad. In memory of the late VP Diouf, President Barrow has declared a 7-day national mourning effective 18th January 2023, with all flags flying at half-mast. The body will be evacuated from India in due course. Upon arrival, he will be laid in state at the National Assembly for a state funeral. Funeral arrangements and programs will be announced later. The former vice president will be remembered forever by Gambians for his service to the nation. Reporting for Kerfatu, I am Buba Gajigo.
Inovrex Global Health ushers in a new way of leveling the playing field by increasing access to quality healthcare products and services for all Gambians. IGH services include accurate point-of-care clinical lab tests with results ready in minutes and delivered electronically. Doctor consultations are available up to 7 days a week at the facility or virtually. A community pharmacy with the US-sourced prescription medication with personalized labels and up to 60 tablets for only 300 dalasis. Shop quality products like vitamins and supplements, pain relief, personal care, first aid, dental hygiene, and more. You can get it delivered anywhere in the Gambia, from Banjul to Basse. Visit the facility at Fatou Golden Plaza, Bertil Harding Highway, opposite Election House, or visit our website at www.igh.gm. For more information, text 1881 or call us on 2866200 or 3866200.
For the first time in the history of the Gambia, Gambia Printing Publishing Corporation proudly introduces the Biliomatic Exercise Book Printing Machine. The machine has the capacity to print more than 20,000 books per hour. Yes, 20,000 books per hour. It also prints magazines, newspapers, calendars, flyers, normal books, and all kinds of printed documents plus items at affordable prices. With the Biliomatic printing machine, GPPC can now render high quality and non-size restricted printing service supply across the sub-region. Rush now and partner with GPPC for all your public and private printing service needs. Print with us today and you'd be offered highly professional, reliable and efficient service delivery by our team of experts. The Gambia Printing and Publishing Corporation is here to meet all demands and is reliable at all times. For more info, contact us on 437-4493 or 437-4402. GPPC is Gambian, and it's yours.
If you are thinking of a bank that takes care of customers' needs by providing quality services with flexibility, reliability, and innovation, think Trust Bank Limited. With Trust Bank Limited mobile banking, you enjoy services such as balance inquiry, mini statement, funds transfer between accounts, exchange rates, mobile airtime top-up, stop ATM card, checkbook request, and PIN change. Our real-time gross settlement allows the customer to instruct the bank to transfer funds from their account to another account at another bank. Our expertise and experience in international banking is both legendary and the envy of the market. Retail banking, one bank, different amazing packages. Whether you are interested in savings account, current account, time or fixed deposit account, lending or overdraft, our team of dedicated staff is always ready and willing to help you out with your transactions as you wish. Corporate banking. Trust Bank Limited offer the most convenient services for deposit accounts, credit facilities, trade finance, bond and guarantee, and foreign currency account. With e-banking, you can make electronic bill payments and online banking and enjoy 24-hour access to your cash with our ATM. With the largest network of branches and agents, we give you the convenience to receive funds as you please. Trust Bank Limited, proudly Gambian.